Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Dr. Tariq Mia, President, Academy of Family Physicians, Pakistan. Just a few words about the history of Pakistan Academy of Family Physicians. Its founder is Dr. Bashir Malik, who started CME programs at his private hospital. And there were very few members in the beginning, but gradually the number increased day by day. We salute our hero, Dr. Bashir Malik, who really did a great job. He thought that the family physicians, they don't have any continuing medical education program, and the medical knowledge is changing day by day. So, according to his vision, he started the CME program at a very small level at his clinic. But later on, as the people felt the importance of CME, so they came into the arena of Pakistan Society of Family Physicians at that time. So gradually, with the passage of time, the people all over the country, they thought that the CME program is very essential and we cannot grow without this program. I thought that if we represent the community, then we must expand the infrastructure of Academy of Family Physicians. So in the beginning, we started chapters of Academy of Family Physicians in Lahore. So we divided Lahore into 23 chapters, and there are different office bearers of each chapter, and they are doing their CME program at their own level. The center is doing as a whole CME program in different teaching hospitals. The main objective of Pakistan Academy of Family Physicians was, number one, CME program. Number two, the problems of medical profession as a whole and the family physician in particular. And number three, the community work. So why there was need of continuing medical education program? The doctors are doing house job in one or two subjects. So we started this program, and we are covering almost whole body, every system of the body. In this way, the doctors, our members, they are equipped with the latest knowledge, which is expanding day by day, and the world of medical science is changing. So the new guidelines and the new research is coming in. So according to that need, we train our family physicians who do different CME programs, different workshops, hands-on training, so that our family physician who is sitting, who don't have any such program from the government side, so on our own, we are providing this facility to our members. And in this way, they are indirectly, they are giving the latest research, the latest knowledge to the patients, and the patients are benefiting at a very low cost at near their doorstep. Pharmaceutical persons and even the consultants who come into our CME programs, they have seen a lot of change in the family physicians. They are now full of knowledge with the latest guidelines. Due to this continuing medical education program, the family physicians, they have again opened the books. They are now equipped with the internet, and they are connected to the internet, and so they themselves, they are seeking knowledge in the world. So this was one of the big service provided by Academy of Family Physician. Secondly, the family physician, according to WHO, they are providing 70 to 80% health needs of the country. So they are providing services to 80% of the masses. So the 20% is being done by the public sector hospitals. So the need of the family physician is at most. It was first time in the epidemic of dengue in 2011 when the public hospitals were choked, and the 80% load was seen by the family physician. Chief Minister of Punjab realized that we cannot cope with this high level epidemic without the help of family physician. Now we are in different committees of government, this epidemic control committee, like hepatitis control, dengue control, like tuberculosis, like immunization, family planning, and many different committees. If a government agrees to the referral system, like in UK and other countries, that no patient should be visited the public sector hospital until and unless he is being referred by the family physician. This is the only solution that we can reduce the huge rush at teaching hospitals and public sector hospitals. We are forcing the government to make the arrangement for the referral system and train the family physician in referring the patient, and these patients who are referred by the family physician, they must be referred back to the family physician. In this way, there will be indirect learning for primary care physician. The family physicians, they are facing a lot of problems. They are not provided with the free medical facilities at government hospitals. I think the government must look into it. They must give the treatment to family physicians as a priority, because they are honorable member of this profession and it is their right to enjoy the services of a public sector hospital. Secondly, there are a lot of problems at their clinics due to awareness in the media. Now they are not going to realize that there are natural complications of treatment. The media must teach the public that there are few natural complications which every patient coming to the hospital cannot be cured. We can only try our best that the patient must be cured. I think those who are opting family practice, who are opting primary care physician, the government must have a rotatory job for them, so that they should be given training in every subject so that he can see the patient. And if he has not having knowledge, he cannot refer the patient even to the tertiary care hospital, because he is not knowing that disease. In this way, if we are training such doctors for family physicians, for family practice, these doctors will be more beneficial to the public. There will be no negligence. Government made Punjab Healthcare Commission. We, the Pakistan Academy of Family Physicians, we were the pioneer to look into that draft. There was a very huge fines in that law. So we, with the help of all the organization, including PMA and Medical Teachers Association and Specialist Association and many other associations, and then we made another law. This was passed through Punjab Assembly, and the Punjab Healthcare Commission came into being. The main objective was that there's no police case should be registered against a doctor until unless there is inquiry by professional people, the doctors of that field, so that they can decide that whether there was negligence of that doctor or that was a natural complication. Secondly, there was a lot of problem of the menace of quackery. So these two things, that the quackery will be eradicated in this country, it was decided that the rules and regulations will be made with the help of stakeholders. So we are now forcing the Punjab Healthcare Commission that all this minimum service delivery standards, fee structure and complaint management, that should be done with consultation of stakeholders. At the end of each year, we are having a big conference, that is FamilyCon. The public knows that FamilyCon is the biggest conference of medical profession of Pakistan Academy of Family Physicians registered. So now we are holding our mid-year conference at Pindi, and now this year at Hyderabad. So I think we will be expanding this conferences to other provinces, other districts, so that family physicians of that area must be benefited with this conference. In conference, we have about many experts, not only from Pakistan, but also from abroad, reporting their knowledge to the family physician. So whenever there is any natural calamity, Pakistan Academy of Family Physician is there to serve the people. I will give few examples. When there was earthquake in northern areas, we went to different areas of Azad Kashmir to help our people. Then there was a time when the people were displaced from Swat, and they were in camps. So we arranged medical camps for them. Then for the last few years, there was a lot of floods, particularly in the South Punjab. So we sent hundreds of teams to different areas of South Punjab to help the people. We sent teams to the Balochistan in the dengue in 2011 epidemic. We trained a lot of our family physicians. There was a compliment from a Sri Lankan doctor. We asked that what about the family physicians and how they have controlled with the epidemic of dengue in their country. They said if this type of family physicians were available to them in Sri Lanka, they have controlled this ahead of time. So they appreciated the services, the knowledge of the family physician of Pakistan. We are collaborating with other organizations. Now there is no conference in this country who is the conference of a specialty, but they are having a special session for family physician. So in future, we are going to collaborate with the different international universities to having different courses for the family physicians. And secondly, we are introducing the culture of research for the family physician in this country. We are also planning with the help of Punjab Health Foundation that there should be a joint clinics of those patients, those doctors having different specialties and different diagnostic facilities at one place. There is a group practice, then if somebody is on leave, he can be replaced by other doctors. We are planning the health insurance of our members. As the people has seen the efforts of the office bearer, a lot of work for the community. So now the people, they love to become the member of this organization because they feel honored that now the family physician, they are very much respected community. And now due to this continuing medical education, now their knowledge is enhancing. They are doing post-graduation like MRCGP, like MCPS in family medicine. And we are collaborating with College of Physician and Surgeon. And I must mention that Professor Zafrullah Chaudhary, Professor Khalid Masood Gondal, they are helping a lot in doing different programs for the family physician. There are many other organizations who are training our doctors, like Fatima Memorial Hospital Rheumatology Department. They have started the rheumatology course for the family physician. We must salute Professor Nigat Meer, Dr. Samira Raja, and Dr. Ahmed Saeed, and their colleagues who are doing this program for family physician. When the patient come to consultant, the disease is very much delayed. By the training of family physician, the disease can be diagnosed at a very early stage, so we can avoid complication. This was an overview of Pakistan Academy of Family Physician. I invite all the doctors from throughout the globe. We have at the moment 2,000 life members and we have 12,000 ordinary members. So I invite rest of the doctors who are not yet in our circle, they must join us and they must enjoy the services being provided by, and they must lead the community, come and join us so that the family physician, the primary care physician can proudly say that we are the real whole body doctor and we will serve our nation with zeal and vigor. At the end, I'll say Pakistan, Zindabad, Pakistan Academy of Family Physicians, Paindabad.